Hi guys, I'm back and I'm here to share with you my top 10 pregnancy tips. So let's jump right in. Okay, my first tip for you is chiropractic and prenatal massage. So I've never done this consistently for any of my pregnancies until this one. So this is my fourth pregnancy, and this time I have twins. So I'm doing everything I can to make myself feel better. I would say wait till third trimester if you don't want to invest in the money because it is expensive. But you can find places like The Joint for chiropractic and Massage Envy for massages that give you better prices, you know, monthly prices, and it's just more simple payments. But I would highly recommend, so chiropractic is going to get your hips in place. You're not going to be as much in pain. And then prenatal massages, obviously that's a given. Who wouldn't want a massage? But I've done both of these consistently the third trimester, and it has been life-changing for me. I'm not in pain, I can walk easily, and it's just enjoyable to get away and get a massage. So that's my number one. Number two, ab elevators. If you don't know what these are, you can Google it. I can't really show you on camera, but if you have diastasis recti, it's when your muscles during pregnancy split apart like natural. It happens to everybody, but some people it doesn't go fully back, and so then you're left with these muscles that are just open, and you obviously, that's not good. Your organs can come through, and crunches don't work. So what you want to do is work out that transverse muscle on the inside that wraps around your back and the front. And what you do is you breathe in and let your stomach out, and then when you breathe out, you bring in that muscle underneath. You can feel it, and you bring it up. It's called an ab elevator because it feels like your abs are lifting up like an elevator. And I do it all the time when I'm not pregnant because I have dealt with ab issues before and have actually healed them. So now when I am pregnant, I'm preparing for that. I'm preparing my muscles to deal with the stretching, especially of twins. There's a lot more stretching. So preparing that, and it also prepares your body for labor because it brings up the pelvic floor and just makes things a lot more easy. You don't feel like you're falling apart as much. So that would be another important thing. Number three, I would say low sugar diet. And along with that, just eating well. It's so obvious, right? But I did not eat well my first pregnancy because I didn't know really what I was doing. You're hungry all the time, so I was just eating fast food. This was about 8 years ago. And yeah, that didn't work out well for me. I gained about 50 pounds and just felt horrible. I got really swollen by the end, like feet swollen, hands swollen, my whole body felt swollen, and I had no energy. So by the time my second pregnancy came along, I really learned how important it is to listen to your body and what it's craving and what that means. And for me, that meant low sugars, so no sodas. I don't think I've had a soda in like 5 years, but no sodas, no high sugar or processed foods. This is the time in pregnancy to really just focus on your diet, that diet that you've always been wanting to do. Do it during pregnancy. Don't restrict calories, but just focus on what you are giving your body, the nutrition that's going in. I drink a lot of smoothies where you can like pack a ton of stuff in there and just drink it down. But in the first trimester, when you're super hungry, just, you know, when you go get that burger, don't get the bun, and just try and keep those sugars low, because, you know, later on with gestational diabetes, that's a pain. This pregnancy has been so much easier for me because I have focused on my diet and I just feel good. I have so much energy, and that's what you want. You don't want to be dreading third trimester because you know you're going to feel bad. You don't have to feel bad in third trimester if you're focusing on your diet. Okay, number four. I would say really important, shop for a doctor. So whether it's a midwife or an OBGYN, whatever you're looking for, write it down on a list and make sure that you get those things, because every doctor is different and every hospital is different. You want to shop for a hospital too. So make sure that your doctor lines up with everything you believe. And you don't, if a doctor does not support you in a way that you want to be supported, look for someone else. So they're working for you and they are your advocate. And so it's up to you to find what you want. So this pregnancy, I actually interviewed like 6 different doctors. And what I've noticed, which is kind of annoying, is that most doctors don't let you interview them anymore. So I actually had to pay for 6 different appointments, but it was that important to me to make sure that I had a doctor that I felt comfortable with. And for me, this pregnancy, what was important for me is a doctor that supported a VBAC with twins. It's crazy how many doctors don't support that. So I found a doctor who's done it for 30 years. Since I couldn't be with a midwife, which would be my ideal situation, I decided, you know, I needed to find an OBGYN. And so I'm thinking, what's the best situation? I want a doctor that supports me giving birth naturally with a VBAC, if possible, if the babies are in the right position and nothing else is wrong. And he totally does. And so just make your list, make sure that that doctor doesn't make you feel bad, doesn't just turn down what's important to you, and the pregnancy will be a lot easier and more joyful for you. Okay, number 5 might sound kind of funny, but I'm completely serious. When you go out and about, when you're late second trimester or third trimester, don't make eye contact with people. So I made this mistake so many times because I'm a friendly person and I generally like people. But when I'm pregnant, I'm not as social because everywhere I go, people have a story for me or they have advice, which is not necessarily bad. But when you have many people doing that to you in a day, it gets really tiring and you almost start to feel like what Justin Bieber may feel like. Maybe not quite that, but oh man, it's a lot, especially with twins when your belly is sticking straight out and there's a lot of attention on it. I just don't make eye contact anymore. So I used to just smile at people everywhere I went, and now I put my head down because you're just asking for people to come and tell you this life story about somebody who was pregnant, somebody that they know 50 years ago who was pregnant. Seriously, I've had people like that. Oh, my mom, you know, 50 years ago had twins or whatever. And then you're standing there with your 3 other kids running around listening to this story and you're like, I gotta go. This happens to me all the time. So it's okay to look down or walk the other way if you just don't want to talk or listen to people's advice about pregnancy or parenting. Number 6, don't stress about weight gain. So my first 3 pregnancies, I was stressed about weight gain. I shouldn't gain more than X amount of pounds. That is not true. And I've learned that with twin pregnancy because it's a totally different ball game. You do have to eat more. But I have a really great book that I'll list below. It's for twin pregnancies, but you can also get some tips for single pregnancies as well on diet and all that. But what I have learned is the more you eat, the more nutrition you get in, the more you're nourishing your baby, and therefore your body doesn't ever have to go into starvation mode and hoard calories. And so it's best to just get in those good calories. And I'm not talking about like, go eat Taco Bell and McDonald's all the time and eat as much as you can. No, because that won't ever end up working out in your favor. So what I'm talking about is mainly nutrition. Like if you're hungry, listen to your body. What is it saying? If you are craving candy, or you're craving a soda, there's probably something very specific your body is actually craving. So what I do is when I'm craving candy, a lot of the time my body wants vitamin C, I found. So I go for a grapefruit, pineapple, and then I'm satisfied and my body feels a lot better. So just listen to your body. Don't be afraid of the calories and don't be afraid of the weight gain. My doctor actually said this time with twin pregnancy, I need to just keep gaining and gaining and gaining because the more I do, the more healthy my babies will be. They won't be in NICU most likely. My babies are already 6 pounds apiece and I'm 35 weeks. So they're growing really, really well and they'll already have enough fat on them for body temperature regulation and all that stuff. So don't be afraid of that. When you walk out of the hospital, you're gonna lose like at least 20 pounds just walking out. At least I do. I'm 20 pounds lighter every time. So just don't worry about it. Nourish your babies, and therefore it'll nourish you too. Number 7 is to invest in good prenatal vitamins and supplements that'll prepare you for labor. So every time I'm pregnant, I get a good prenatal supplement and a good DHA, but also on top of that, I make sure to get stuff that will prepare me for labor. I didn't do this for my first pregnancy, and then my last two pregnancies I did, and it was a world of a difference. So I'm talking about like herbs that are gonna nourish your uterus over the entire pregnancy, and also supplements, vitamins that will make you prepared, because you wouldn't run a marathon and not prepare for it, right? You wouldn't just show up the day of the marathon and be like, I can do this, and then your body gives out on you, your knees give out, and you feel horrible, and you pass out, and yeah, it'd be bad. Labor and delivery is very similar. I mean, sometimes women have 24 plus hour births. I've had a birth that was 22 hours, and it took a lot out of me. My first birth was 12 hours, but it was so traumatic for me, and it's a lot on your body. So you just want to prepare it and make it as easy as possible. Two things that I do religiously every pregnancy is to drink a pregnancy tea that has red raspberry leaf in it, and many other, you can find pregnancy teas on Amazon, and I can link some down below. But what's important about these herbs is that they're nourishing the right things that a woman needs in order to give birth. Also, the second thing that I do is I eat 6 dates per day. So I eat 3 in the morning and 3 at night. And this is supposed to help make labor come on easier. So for example, it makes your cervix softer and it makes you dilate faster, which in turn makes your labor shorter. So nobody wants a 40-hour birth, obviously. So you want to be able to dilate over time slowly and then go to the hospital and they'll be like, oh, you're a 5 already. Well, great. And then you dilate quickly and everything works out better. So that has been really great for me. Dates have oxytocin. They have an oxytocin-like effect on the body. So, and that's what you need in order to have labor. So, okay, my number 9 would be maternity clothes. You do not need the newest, cutest maternity clothes. It's just not necessary. So I've learned, especially this pregnancy, because this is my first pregnancy in the dead of summer, and it's bad. It's so hot. So my suggestion is just wear normal clothes, you know, buy larges as long as you can. And then when you need, I always need maternity pants pretty quick, like around 12 weeks. So invest in good maternity pants, maybe 3 or 4. Get 2 good pair of jeans, 2 pairs of sweatpants or something. And then when it comes to shirts, get basics. Get tank tops and just basic t-shirts that have nothing on them. And then instead, if you're wanting something trendy, invest in a cute hat or jewelry or something like that that you can wear later. Because I've been to the point where I'm like, man, I really want to wear something trendy. And you look on these cute websites and they have trendy pregnancy clothes, and then you wear it once. Yeah, I've done that a lot actually. So, and then you feel bad. You're like, dang it, I can't wear this after pregnancy. So that's a bummer. And then you just wasted money. So I would highly recommend just getting basics, adding things later, and make sure that you get a really good pair of comfortable tennis shoes. Because I am to the point in my pregnancy that I can't wear sandals, I can't go barefoot, I can't wear cute shoes anymore. So I invested in a really good pair of Nikes that I wear with my jeans, with my shorts, goes with everything, and I feel like they're cute and stylish, so, and I'll like them after pregnancy too. Okay, number 10. So I haven't really been going in order. It's not like I've decided that, you know, all these things went in order and this is how I want them to be for the video. No, sorry. But I will say, I didn't think that much into it. But I will say this is my top tip. So number 10, which probably should be number one. I don't know. Sorry about that if that's confusing. My number one tip, which is actually number 10, would be to work out your entire pregnancy. So if you feel good in first trimester, do it. I did not this time. I didn't work out till I think 13 weeks. So my entire second trimester, when I felt the best, which is when most women feel the best, take advantage of that second trimester when you feel normal, you feel good, you don't feel super heavy yet, go to the gym. So I didn't do this. I did walk a lot with my other pregnancies, but this time I actually worked out. I worked out before my pregnancy and carried that over. And it has been the best thing for my pregnancy. So you'd think that a twin pregnancy would be the hardest, right? Not this one. This has actually been my easiest because I worked out. So starting in second trimester until about 32 weeks pregnant, I worked out every weekday. So I went to the gym, took my kids. It was actually kind of my me time. And I'd spend an hour to an hour and a half doing, I wouldn't do my normal workouts. I would definitely, you know, make them easier. Obviously, I'm not like lifting huge weights. But what's important is making sure that your joints and your muscles stay strong and they don't just become noodles, because then your body is not supportive for all that weight. So now that I've gained 55 pounds this pregnancy, it doesn't feel like it as much because I have strengthened all those muscles and gotten them prepared for all this weight and for labor as well. So like today we went on a walk and I was fine because I feel like my body is strong. So when you're at the gym, focus on a lot of like hip exercises. And I did tons of upper body. You don't realize how much of your upper body you use when you're pregnant. So, you know, like leaning forward and back stuff, that can all be fixed if you prepare your body for it and strengthen those muscles. So my favorite exercises up until the end of pregnancy or the end of second trimester were the hip abductor and the hip adductor. So you're strengthening those muscles that surround all those ligaments that end up hurting. So my past three pregnancies, I've had pain in my pelvis where I couldn't walk. This pregnancy, I don't have that at all. I had 1 week where my back hurt and I found out it was actually the baby's position that was making it hurt. So I went to a chiropractor, he moved, and I was fine after that. So it's all about listening to your body. I stopped doing any cardio at all because my body just said no. Every time I'd get on the treadmill and walk, I had contractions and I got out of breath. So my body was saying, nope, don't do that. Whereas my other pregnancies, I walked a lot. So you just have to listen and your body will tell you. So my body was telling me things like cable machine workouts where you're lifting weights with cables. That was good. And it strengthened my muscles a lot in my back and my arms. And then simple leg workouts. I couldn't do any leg workouts with weights, but I could, you know, get on my hands and knees and do leg lifts and things like that. That really helps strengthen my lower body. So that would be my absolute number one tip, is keep working out. You, I promise you, you will feel so much better. So that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope this helped you. If you guys have any tips for me, I would love to hear, because I am about to give birth. So any day now, I would love to hear your tips on what you found helps make pregnancy easier, especially twin pregnancy. If you have anything for that, I'd like to hear that. And check back on our channel because we're going to be doing a birth video soon, and I'd love for you guys to see our new babies. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye.